Agriculture Future in 2030. Groundbreaking changes are expected to occur between now and 2030, leading to a revolution in the agriculture sector. For decades, governments and large organizations have focused on food availability, seeking to make all staple foods of our diet accessible at all times of the year. Lately, however, things have been changing, as new factors have called for a rethinking of the agricultural system as a whole. So, how will food production change over the coming years? Don't forget to watch today's video to the very end for insight on agriculture future in 2030. But before we begin, we request you to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to never miss another upload of ours. Having said that, let's jump right in. Organic farming and new trends. New dietary trends are having an increasing impact on farming practices. Certain sources are an uptrend. The quantity of vegetables found on people's tables has been growing more and more significant as animal-sourced food consumption is falling. People are beginning to prioritize quality and diversity over quantity. According to the European Union report of 2019 to 2030, customers are increasingly demanding when it comes to their food and such issues as health, nutritional properties, origin, sustainability, and animal welfare are gaining crucial importance. The new demand has a decisive impact on cultivated varieties, cultivation methods, and livestock breeding. It's undisputed that certain market sectors, such as those of organic and zero-kilometer products, will grow significantly over the next decade. Community policies in terms of environmental impact have also encouraged certain production practices, such as crop rotation. However, the higher costs associated with some of these changes are offset by the added value of the products. In the same report, the European Agency forecasts that the areas dedicated to agriculture on the continent will decrease by 178 million hectares by 2030. Crops will grow more slowly than in the past, although process in seed selection and management will still help farmers to achieve an overall increase in production, fighting climate change. Climate change will change our production methods in a decisive way, affecting factors such as rainfall, temperatures, and soil quality. Consequently, we must begin to address these changes adopting certain strategies. The new climate change report of the European Environmental Agency offers some recommendations. First and foremost, adopting precision farming tools, which improve production and optimize the application of fertilizers and crop protection chemicals. It also recommends growing crops that are more resistant to heat and cold waves, as well as to drought and pests. Cover crops should be used during the winter period to protect the soil, while generally speaking, crop rotation greatly benefits the soil. Other recommendations from the European Agency for the next decade include optimizing irrigation, sustainable production in greenhouses, and better animal fodder. Climate deniers will soon go the way of the dinosaurs, as there's global consensus that climate change is happening and it's going to continue to have consequences such as more erratic and severe weather, changes to agricultural growing areas, and expanded areas of adoption for some warmer climate crops like corn and soybeans. Many feel that's good news for Canada, which should be able to take advantage of warmer growing seasons if soils can be kept productive and crops developed through genetic advancements to overcome temporary, localized conditions and keep ahead of evolving resistant weeds, pests, and diseases. Soil scientists and many early adopter farmers are also backing the growth of regenerative agriculture with its focuses on improving soil health through plant diversity using different cropping and livestock integration systems, and with its strategy of building up microbial populations to confer more resilience to the overall farm and make it more productive and sustainable. Regenerative, they say, is the only way forward for farming in the future, and will have benefits not just at the farm level, but also environmentally and socially. Scientists feel emerging genetic technologies have the potential to rapidly advance plant breeding and to produce crop varieties that are more resistant to climate and pest issues. Until now as well, farms have focused on expansion through getting more land, but in the future, the focus will shift to producing more on the same or fewer acres, and again, regenerative agriculture, technology, and innovation will have big roles to play. New technologies for agriculture. Lastly, technology is making giant steps forward, and the results will soon be visible. Over the last few years, we've witnessed the introduction of many new technologies. Up until 10 years ago, such tools as isobus and assisted driving would have seemed like science fiction. Today, they're accessible to everyone. More futuristic technologies are expected during the next decade. We might see robots and drones roaming our fields, collecting data and taking care of our crops with increasing accuracy. Fertilization, weeding, and even harvesting might be managed by artificial intelligence, while next-generation robots will also be able to offer suggestions on how to optimize production and increase crop yields. Agricultural drones will be used in land mapping and problem detection. They're also likely to be used to spray crops quickly and precisely in the future, without wasting chemicals, thanks to sophisticated equipment. Data collection will also be integrated with satellite crop monitoring systems to keep things under control at all times, and gather exhaustive information so as to take action quickly if necessary. However, new technologies are not just about digital machinery and tools. As a matter of fact, genetic engineering will play a very important role. We're all familiar with GMOs. However, new breeding techniques are emerging as the new front line now. Using the genome editing technique to modify specific parts of plant genes, it's now possible to obtain new plant varieties that are more productive and more resistant, much faster than traditional crossbreeding and hybridization techniques would allow. More about robots and digitalization. Technology is the fun area to speculate on as we see the current advances in things such as robotics, autonomous tractors and driverless cars, artificial intelligence, equipment that will make decisions in the field, and digitization of data. Although technology seems limitless in its possibilities, the biggest hurdle is the issue of managing and connecting all of the data so that it will empower farmers and the agricultural industry to make informed decisions, seamlessly and across multiple management platforms and equipment types. When we crack that nut and begin to decentralize data, the rewards in terms of efficiency, productivity, and profitability will be huge. There are a few provisions in the future view of interconnectivity and collaborative technologies, though. And the biggest one is that we still have a long way to go before rural Canada has good internet and wireless connectivity that can make all of these advances seamless. Consumers, traceability, and food security. The foundation of the AG pyramid will always be the consumer, and trends towards more plant-based diets and towards foods that are more nutritionally dense and flavorful will strengthen over the next decade. Consumers will also insist on knowing how their food is raised or grown. Traceability processes that focus on food production from farm to plate are already well established, and that's only going to become more feasible and transparent as digitization and integration of primary agriculture and the rest of the value chain continues. Food may soon carry a climate-friendly label, and the global food industry will also be more concerned about food security than in the past. Will there be more mouths to feed? It's uncertain. Many believe that we'll see a rapidly burgeoning world population in 10 years, that agriculture will need to find ways to feed them, although others suggest fertility rates in many developed countries are already in decline, in some cases lower than replacement rate, and that the developing world is beginning to turn that corner too. Markets and rural youth. Markets will be more transparent in the future thanks largely to the connectivity that is bound to provide better access to information about the state of crop production worldwide, and how that reflects at the market and farm level in real time. Farmers already consult their phones to see a visualization of the markets at that exact moment, and compare them against historical averages and trends. The future will be the same, only a million times more powerful. It's also heartening to learn, through speaking with rural development people, that rural population isn't in decline, as many people believe. In fact, it's growing, just at a slower rate than urban populations. That's not to say that there aren't pockets of rural Canada that aren't struggling, but others, Morden and Winkler in South Central Manitoba, for example, are among the fastest growing communities in the country. What will prove vital is to make opportunities for young people to stay and work in rural areas, and to encourage them to pursue careers in agriculture, whether it's on or off the farm. Again, a lot of great work is already being done in this area, but some experts feel the message needs to reach kids earlier about the agricultural possibilities available to them, especially as technology advances and the industry will be crying out for data management, communication, and IT specialists who can basically work remotely from anywhere. Whatever the future holds, one thing is certain. Agriculture is an industry bursting with innovation and smart people, and it's going to adapt and help find solutions to economic, environmental, social, and humanitarian dilemmas that face the world, as it always has. With that, we come to the end of today's video. If you enjoyed our content, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Lastly, join in next time for more of such interesting content.